like those people. Anyway, from the SCTV network, now it's time for the nighttime version of Halfwits, and here's the star of Halfwits, Alex Trebell! Well, thank you, Johnny Ola, amazing that we do sound alike. And good evening, everybody! Welcome to Halfwits, the game show that's fun and at times extremely trying. If you've been with us for the past 2 weeks, you'll know that our contestants are all tied for the lead, all at zero. No correct answers thus far. 2 weeks, nothing even remotely close to correct, but we're hoping to break that deadlock tonight. But first, let's meet our contestants, Darren Peel. Darren, good to have you back.
Thank you, Alex, and we'd like to have you over for dinner sometime.
Now, Darren, you were telling us you're in machine parts. Is that correct?
Yeah, that's correct, Alex. I have ball bearings in my... I do ball bearings for a living. I have 2 pails at work. 1 pail for good ball bearings and 1 pail for bad balls.
Well, that sounds like a very demanding job.
It is for me.
I believe it. Darren, you're a family man. Is that correct?
Yes, Alex. I have 2 wonderful parents. I have a mother and a father and another brother named Darren.
What I meant to say was, do you have a family of your own?
I don't follow you.
Do you have a wife? Do you have children? Do you have a family of your own?
Sure I do. I have a wonderful wife and 2 boys named Frank.
Well, good to have you here, Darren. Good luck. And now we say hello to Blanche Redd.
That's correct, Alex.
We got us a live one here.
I didn't say yet. Did I mention my wife?
Well, yes, you did, Darren.
And my 2 boys and Frank?
I no longer care. Now, Blanche, I believe you are our secretary. Is that correct?
Yes, that's correct, Alex.
I work for Mr. Hargrove.
I see. And what line of work is your employer?
He's the boss, Alex.
Blanche, you're telling us that you're single.
Yes, that's correct, Alex. I'm single and unattached.
Well, absolutely good for you.
Thank you, Alex.
Moving on to AF Arthur Andrew Liggett. Arthur, you were telling us before that you were in medical research. Would you care to elaborate on that?
I lied.
I'm sorry.
I lied. I thought it would sound good for TV.
Fabulous. Well, what exactly do you do for a living, Arthur?
Well, it's a job. Nothing special.
What kind of a job?
Just a job. You know, a normal job.
What do you do for a living?
I work.
Where?
Around!
Oh my god. Oh my god. Well, as you can see, we seem to feel that we do not have time for this. Our fourth guest and final guest, we seriously hope he has a list of a smidgen of a brain, Lawrence Orbach. Lawrence, you were telling us you're still in school.
Righto, Alex.
Postgraduate work?
No, high school. I'm having a degree of difficulty getting through high school.
I see. Well, not surprisingly, good to have you here. I'm sure you'll do it.
Certain goals
in
life, but I feel compelled to complete.
Very, very good.
One of which is becoming a circuit court judge.
Good. It's good to have ambition.
And the second is perhaps playing professional hockey.
Okay, now it's time to play Halfwits. If you remember when the final buzzer went off yesterday, along with my mind, Darren Peel had just picked the category European cuisine. Now listen carefully. I'm looking for one culinary dish from Italy. Blanche Ray?
Italy! Could it be it's cheese omelets?
Cheese omelets! Unbelievable! I'm sorry, that answer is incorrect. Do not all wave your hands. Use your bells! Thank you, Darren Peel.
Is it spare ribs?
Spare ribs. No, I'm sorry, that answer, shockingly, is incorrect. I'm looking for a dish from Italy! Swedish meatballs! Lawrence, can I ask you a question? Where the hell do you think Swedish meatballs come from? Arthur Andrew Liggett? Well, we seem to have exhausted that relatively simple category, so I'll tell you what I'm going to do. I can no longer deal with this. Therefore, the winner is going to be the one who picks the number closest in my mind from 1 to 10. Darren Peel, pick a number.
12!
A number from 1 to 10! Blanche!
12?
Arthur, Andrew, Liggett, any number, just pick a number.
That's the number I wanted 12.
Lawrence Orbach.
Oh, I think I've lost track now. Can you repeat the number?
All right, we're out of time. time and I'm out of patience. I'm resigning right now and I'm going over to work for a show where intellect is king. You'll see me on the Jerry Springer Show. Thank you, everyone. I'm not sure who asked for which one first. So Lead Your Own is ahead. Cool. You guys come up and do Lead Your Own. Yes, let's do Lead Your Own. Then we'll do God. Okay? Lead Your Own. That was fun. Thanks.
Oh,
okay.
Evelyn, I
cried.
All right, cool.
Evelyn is a
crier.
All right.
What are you doing this every week? Make it real, Janet.
I need Holly. Coach me.
This coach sucks.
He's mean.
You know. Your favorite hole, Sheldon.
I just gotta find a
other than that, you're
don't know.
you know, this is my wife's first time in front of an audience.
That's not true.
If you please did, I got another one for you.
Yeah. She's been in the front of an audience before. She's good. She's great.
Thank you.
Which one?
Okay, so we do have, we actually do have a microphone here. I can actually turn up the sound. So if we want to use the microphone, we can. Okay? So I'm going to turn the sound up on it if someone wants to get to it.
You want cake?
Yeah, I know what it's about.
Yes, I know what it's said.
Just so that we're represented. That's what the badge is about. You don't know what we're doing.
Oh, it's fine. There's a lady in the sound. It's all just. Yes, I'm the Johnson Church.
They have a cake. It's rather by this way.
I don't think you are kidding. I give you the 912.
What's
a 9-12. Insulting an officer's intelligence. I was just trying to right a wrong that I don't think was wrong in the first place. Come on, Vaughn, give me a ticket. Don't give me a ticket. We're pals.
That simply does not enter into it. Now, my oath simplifies that I'm to uphold the law. If my mother made a U-turn, I'd give her a ticket. There you are, a $5 fine, payable within 1 week. Failure to do so may result in imprisonment or a $100 fine, or both, as a jurisdiction of the court, so the jurisdiction of the court may so decide.
You just go.
What was that?
You just go up an alley and haul a fish. I said it, and I ain't taking it back neither.
Gomer, I try to look away from this and set it aside, will you? You see, you broke the law. Now let me finish. Now it's from little misdemeanors and major felonies grow, and it's my duty and anybody's duty to stop them before you even get too far. Now, the law must be upheld. Now, if you just plain Jane Doe, an ordinary citizen, we're here to see you making a U-turn. I have to make a citizen's arrest. Gomer, you'll be a better man if you'll just try to think of us as working together in common cause. All right, everybody, break it up, break it up. Back to your homes or places of business. Oh, give me a break. Let's go.
Stop, Bonnie. Stop. Citizen's arrest. Citizen's arrest. Citizen's arrest. Citizen's arrest. Citizen's arrest.
What are you yelling at me for?
Like you broke the law by making a legal U-turn. You've done it. I hereby, as citizens of the town of Mayberry in the United States of America, arrest you.
Now, just a minute. What are you talking about?
You made a U-turn. As a law-abiding citizen, it's my duty to call you on it. You're supposed to be setting an example for the rest of us.
Now, Gomer, just a minute. That little black and white baby here is a real emergency vehicle. Now, why don't you just stop trying to get even?
But you weren't at no emergency call. You made a mistake, deputy. Now, write yourself a ticket.
You gotta be kidding.
You hear, folks? There are two sets of laws. One for the police and one for ordinary citizens.
What's going on here?
Yelling. Oh, this boob here.
Serving 5 days in jail instead of paying that fine.
All right, we got
got the Brubaker brothers in one sub, so you gotta have to share the other sub with Otis.
I was a little rash.
I think you're right. I would just put back on patrol.
And for sure.
Thank you.
As far as first, but you're all your own people, so just